Over 95% of correctional officers at the Bordelais Correctional Facility did not report for duty on Wednesday. The apparent industrial action came a day after a meeting with the executive of the Correctional Officers Welfare Association and the general membership. Deputy Director of Corrections Leonard Terrence says the executive had asked to meet with its members to discuss matters relating to health and safety concerns brought to the government's attention.
As we showed up for work today, as the management of the facility ended up for work today, we realized that the majority of the officers who attended the meeting, and some of them who may not have attended the meeting, did not report for duty this morning, except for the senior officers and probably two other lower-ranking officers.
In April this year, the executive of the Welfare Association met with Prime Minister Philip Pierre in the hopes that their long-standing issues would be addressed. At a press conference on Wednesday, Prime Minister Philip Pierre said that the government has been working to meet the demands of the security personnel since that engagement.
Bordelais is under the public service, and all promotions to Bordelais, they have to go through the public service, not like the police force, where promotions up to inspector are done by the executive, by the commissioner of police. So you find all promotions must go to the Public Service Commission, and that takes some time. I explained that easy to them. In fact, I took the initiative in speaking to them, because Bordelais is not under my jurisdiction, it's under the Ministry of Home Affairs, but they were complaining of not getting the responses they want, so I decided to speak to them. So it's very unfortunate, and I'd be very sad if that happened, because they got the things that they wanted. They wanted radios, but the radios are being ordered. You see, what they want can happen instantly. We have to change the laws.
A contingency plan has been put in place at the prison to address the decreased security personnel at the facility. An estimated 170 correctional officers are employed with the prison, providing security over the inmate population of 571. Assistance is being provided by the Royal St. Lucia Police Force in the absence of the officers.
The majority of the operations at the facility were able to continue to be. We cannot afford to have part adjourned because of the implications for that. The inmates are being cared for in terms of their meals, and in a number of the cases, their medical needs are attended to. As we speak, we have this company, this philanthropic company here, who are providing some dental health services to the inmates. They are doing extractions, and they are also doing some fillings with the inmates here.
The Deputy Director of Corrections has expressed hope that the outstanding issues between the correctional officers and the government will be resolved in short order. For the DBS News World, I am Zin Romulus.